everybody, it's the Millennial TV. I am GWendoline Chang. Thank you for watching us. And here I have Bruce Coane with us. He is the Houston Super Dad and our top immigration and employment attorney. So, hi, thank you for being here.
Great to be here, thanks.
Great, and so tell us a little bit about your background.
My background. So I grew up in Philadelphia. Mm-hmm. I went to Penn State.
Okay.
And it was very cold there. So as soon as I could get away after graduation, I moved south.
Smart.
Went to law school here at University of Houston.
Houston.
And became a lawyer from there and got married, had a bunch of kids, and the rest is history.
Yes. So a lot of people don't consider attorneys or entrepreneurs, but don't you think you guys are actually one of the real entrepreneurs out there? It's tough business, isn't it?
Yeah, when you're in practice for yourself, and I run a law firm of eight lawyers, you really do have to do some marketing to generate business, to people to come in. So over the years, I've tried to get my name out there and let people know what I do and that I'm there to help folks.
Okay, so what made you decide to do immigration, to focus on immigration and employment law?
I think I fell into both of those, actually.
Okay.
So for immigration, when I was in law school, a lot of students at U of H were from other countries, and they'd ask me immigration questions. And I said, well, I'm just a law student, but when I get out, I'll be happy to try to help you. So I kind of fell into that.
Okay.
And then on employment law, in my first year of practice, some guy from Iran came into my office and said I was fired from my job for being from Iran.
Okay.
And I took his case and found it interesting and just stayed doing employment law at the same time.
Okay, wow. So you would say you enjoy it?
Yeah, I actually love what I do. I've been doing it for over 30 years, and I still love both practice areas.
Oh, that's amazing. Wow. And then how did you know, like growing up, that law is something, it's an area of interest, that you actually really want to do this?
Well, actually, I had no idea what I wanted to do growing up. So I just kind of fell into it.
Yeah.
And when I was at Penn State, I picked this major called pre-law.
Okay.
So when I graduated, there's not a whole lot you can do with a degree in pre-law other than you go to law school. But I never was really passionate about it. I just kind of fell into it when I was in college.
Okay, but you turned out to be a really good one.
Oh, thank you.
So tell us more about these two areas of practice. What do you focus on most?
Sure. Well, in immigration law, I focus on everything involving immigration, so I don't pick any particular area. Some people specialize.
Okay.
And I'm board certified as a specialist in immigration, but I do everything.
Okay.
So I do immigration court, business immigration, family immigration. And on the employment law, we typically represent employees, although about 10% of our practice is representing employers. And on the employee side, we're typically representing people that got fired or they're having problems at work, and we try to guide them on protecting their legal rights, even though they may be working in a state like Texas or Florida where there's at-will employment, where you can be fired for any reason or no reason at all.
Yes.
But people don't realize they have legal rights even in states like that.
Okay, that's interesting. Good to know. And, well, so do you guys actually draft any contracts for companies for, like, employment contracts?
We try to avoid that, actually.
Okay, why is that?
We like drafting lawsuits, but drafting agreements isn't really our thing.
Okay.
We will edit agreements.
Okay.
So we get agreements from the other side on our cases all the time.
Okay, the other side, you mean the
usually
employer?
The defense side, the employer side.
Okay, yeah.
So, and that could be an employment agreement. Like, we've represented doctors before.
Mm-hmm.
And when they go to work, they get a contract, a big contract.
Yeah.
So I won't write those contracts, but I'll edit them.
And
when we settle cases, we get big settlement agreements, and same thing, the other side writes them and we edit them.
Oh, that's smart. Get the other side to do the work.
There you go. Exactly.
Yes. Well, so, and you mentioned that you have eight employees so far?
Eight lawyers.
Eight lawyers.
Yeah,
eight lawyers. How many in total?
We've got 15 between our two offices in Houston and Miami.
Okay. And then do you find management, any difficulties, any challenges in management?
Well, that managing a, I think managing any business is a challenge, and the more workers you have, the more challenging it can be. So, yeah, that's a little bit challenging.
Okay, so what made you decide to do two locations so far away, and you have to travel, and you have family, just so much work and things.
Yeah, a lot of people ask me that. I just went to Miami about 20 years ago and fell in love with the place.
Okay.
And eventually decided to open an office there. So I started in Texas.
Yes.
And I've had the Miami office for about 20 years. Mm-hmm. And almost on a weekly basis, I've been flying back and forth for almost 20 years.
Wow. You must love traveling.
Yeah, as long as it's that flight between Houston and Fort Lauderdale, it's almost always on time. So, good.
Now, are you also licensed to practice in Florida?
No, I don't have a state license in Florida. Okay. I'm admitted to one of the federal courts there, but we employ Florida lawyers. So
right.
We got one, two, three Florida lawyers right now.
Okay. Yeah. Wow. So, any regrets in, you know, being the manager of your company, you know, and then devote yourself in this career?
No, I really love my career. I love to help people. And fortunately, I picked two areas of law where I'm really able to help individuals, to help people. So that's very rewarding. Sometimes it's financially rewarding as well, but it's certainly rewarding to help people.
Mm-hmm.
And so, no, I don't really have any regrets with what I ended up doing.
Okay.
Perhaps I could have made more money doing something else, but I'm really happy with what I'm doing.
That's fantastic. I'm so glad hearing that. And so what would you encourage people, especially law students?
Well, for law students, there was a time during the recent recession where it was hard to get a job.
Yes.
But now it's hard for me to find enough good people to hire.
Oh, really?
So I think things are changing, certainly here in Texas.
Okay.
Maybe the market's not as great for law students becoming lawyers in Florida, or at least South Florida, where we're at.
Okay.
Maybe because so many people want to live there.
Yes.
But here in Texas, I think it's a great opportunity, great opportunities out there for law students because I know law firms are hiring.
Okay. What about any warnings about building your own empire, having your own law firm?
I think to have your own law firm, I mean, you need to have a sense of business because you are running a business.
Yes.
And so I always recommend to people not just to hang out your shingle, but to go work for somebody first and see how that business works.
Okay.
And, you know, for lawyers that set out on their own, there's a lot involved in a business. There's lots of types of insurance you need. Bills to pay. I mean, you need to have some knowledge of accounting to be able to do those sorts of things. Mm-hmm. And certainly a business sense. If you have a business sense, I think you can do it.
What about networking? How important is networking?
Networking is really important. We find we get the most referrals from either happy clients or other lawyers.
Okay.
And so networking with other lawyers, at least for our business, for our practice, is very important.
Okay, so do you do this yourself, or you actually get other people to do it?
Ideally, everybody in the firm does networking. Some do it more than others, but I probably do it the most.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Well, that sounds all fantastic. Well, thank you so much for coming.
Sure.
We enjoyed it. Well, everybody, thank you so much for watching. And please remember to follow us on social medias, the Millennial TV. Thank you.